वेलकम टू एनएमई आईसीटी साक्षर ई कंटेंट प्रोजेक्ट अंडर मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ एचआरडी गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया। दिस प्रोजेक्ट इज ऑफ मार्केटिंग मैनेजमेंट। द प्रोजेक्ट इज अंडर एनएमई आईसीटी, दैट इज नेशनल मिशन ऑन एजुकेशन थ्रू इंफॉर्मेशन एंड कम्युनिकेशन टेक्नोलॉजी। अंडर दिस मिशन अ प्रॉपर बैलेंस बिटवीन कंटेंट जनरेशन, research in critical areas relating to imparting of education and connectivity for integrating our knowledge with the advancement in other countries is to be attempted. In order to bolster our knowledge resources to obtain and maintaining the competitive edge in the world, we require a system of identification and nurturing of talent and lifelong learning. Knowledge modules based on personalized needs of the learner would need to be delivered to him or her at the right time with the right content interactively to take care of his or her aspirations. With these objectives in mind, these videos are created for the portal section. We will learn basic marketing over here.
Hi, I am LL means learner. I am learner of marketing management. I learn marketing in master's class. The desire for learning marketing comes out of interest. This is very interesting topic. Marketing management is seen everywhere in the society. You see up or down, you see here and there, you can see brand names and logos and advertisements and people working in marketing area. I am very much interested in learning marketing. Let us learn marketing from Dr. J. Badayani. He is going to teach marketing management under Sakshat e-Content Development Project under National Mission on Education through Information and Communication Technology, that means NMEICT. Let us start learning. Good morning to all. Today, we are going to learn concept, nature and scope of marketing.
Consumers and other buyers always want higher quality, lower prices and better services. Aggressive competitors try to increase their market share through constant innovation and product improvement, and by satisfying their customers' need and want as effectively as possible on all fronts. To survive and to operate possibly, all other organizations must practice marketing and they must adopt their marketing strategies to keep pace with market changes. The very nature of marketing is often misinterpreted. Some think that marketing is a modern form of selling or it is simply another word for advertising. Selling and advertising are needed important marketing functions, but marketing involves much more. It includes a great number of other activities that enhance an organization's ability to satisfy need and want of its customers effectively, thereby strengthening its position within the market. These other activities include marketing research and product development. Marketing research is conducted to identify the desire of customers, for example, or to size up the competition. Product development is the process of developing and launching attractive products based on accurate insight into market. Let's think about the meaning of the marketing. Marketing is a broad subject. It includes all activities that bring buyers and sellers together. To gain an insight into the meaning of marketing, we begin by looking at difference between marketing and selling. Then we examine a definition of marketing and so-called marketing mix and the exchange process between the buyer and seller. Basically, the difference between selling and marketing can be explained in different manner. Broadly speaking, companies do two things. They market products and they put them in the market. In other words, they produce something and they are involved in marketing. Not long ago, we would have said that they produce something and sell something. The difference between marketing and selling is the difference between a society in which the consumers can choose from products and services designed to meet their specific need and the want, and a society in which people have very little, if any, choice. Marketing builds a bridge between production and consumption. The type of products available in the store and the quality of those products are both determined by the preference of consumers. In short, selling is trying to get rid of what you have on the shelves, while the marketing is making sure that what you have on the shelf is what the customer wants. Essentially, the objective of marketing is to make selling, in the sense of putting preference to others, unnecessary. The purpose of marketing is to get to know and understand the consumer so well that the product is precisely what the consumer wants. Then the product will sell itself. In fact, the need to be familiar with the desire of customer and to establish an ongoing relationship with them is a part of our definition of marketing. Marketing requires not only an appropriate product but also right type of distribution, the right price and the right kind of promotion. Together, these factors make up the so-called marketing mix. If any of these four elements is lacking, a product will not achieve the sale and the profit objective as listed in the annual plan or marketing plan. Not only will the company fail to maximize sales and profit, the target, the potential buyer for whom the product was intended, will probably be left with the unsatisfied need and want. With this example in mind, let's now look at the formal definition of marketing. Say, marketing is the process of developing, pricing, promoting, and distributing products, services, or ideas that are tailored to market. It includes all sorts of activities that create values and simultaneously lead to increased sales or other desired responses, establish a good reputation, and ongoing relationship with customers, so all the stakeholders achieve their objectives. The marketers are not only involved in advertising and selling, but on the basis of marketing research, marketers also decide which products are developed, for whom the products are intended, and how they are introduced. By providing information about the need and want of both potential and current customers, marketers influence the decision-making process at the very inception of the product or services. So, our definition immensely dispels the misconception that the marketing is a kind of superior selling that starts at the end of the production line. The marketing mix. An effective marketing strategy consists of a clear combination of four marketing instruments that are used to tackle the market. These marketing tools are often referred as the marketing mix or the four P's. The marketing mix variables are closely related to one another. If we change one of them, this may have consequences for the other three. Essentially, it creates an entirely new mix. Let's see the product. Product are the goods, services or ideas that meet the want and the need of the customer. But the physical product is P includes other factors that determine which brand the person buys, such as the warranty, packaging, the brand image, the product range and the services. Hence, product strategy is concerned with, among other things, the development of new products and the services, the refinement of existing products, and the decision to take products off the market when they do not have longer to satisfy a need. On the other hand, price. On the other hand, is the amount of the money exchanged for the product or services. When developing a price policy, a company will consider not only the product's manufacturing cost but also price being charged by the competitors and how an increase or reduction in the selling price is likely to affect the demand. If the price is too high, it will deter customers, but if the price is too low, revenue will suffer. When determining the price, several questions needed to be addressed. Should pricing generate a profit in the short term or in the long term? Is a discount necessary? Are some buyers prepared to pay the higher price for more refined products, and who are they? Now let's come to the place. Place basically is a distribution, how the company gets its product into the hands of buyers. How a product is distributed often matter more in determining its success than the product itself. Because of their contacts with the retail trade, companies such as Philips and Universe often stand a better chance for achieving success than do smaller companies when bringing new products into market. Distribution policy is concerned with decision about which distribution channels and intermediaries should be used, the number of sale outlets, the necessary stock level, and the best form of transportation. An efficient distribution system ensure that the right products are on sale in the right place in the right time. Let's talk about the promotion. The activities a supplier implements to communicate with the market and to promote sales. A very few products sell themselves. Potential buyers first have to be made aware of the product and its benefits. Effective communication is needed to inform, persuade, or in case of established brands, remind them for a product. Promotion or marketing communication include advertising, sponsorship, sales promotion, direct marketing and personal selling, and the public relationship activities including free publicity. Developing a promotional strategy requires various decisions such as establishing communication objectives, determining advertising budgets, and the selecting the best combination of the promotional instruments and media. Other decisions include using displays efficiently, offering special discounts, attending trade fairs, and finally assessing the effect of these promotional activities. Now there is a question about the target market selection and the process of exchange. A well thought out marketing mix increases the chance of success. However, because it is impossible to devise and implement a marketing strategy satisfying need of all consumers, companies must concentrate on desires of a specific group of potential buyers. The group of customers is known as the target market. The part of market and an organization concentrates on the want to turn into customers. Customers, after all, are the loyal consumers who will make repeat purchases. Once a company has divided the market into market segment on the basis of certain criteria, it will select one or more target market. With this group of organization, try to bring about an exchange in which two parties agree to exchange something of value so that both parties' needs are met. The exchange transactions underlies all marketing activities. In fact, organizations develop a marketing strategy to stimulate this process of exchange. Exchange transactions are items of worth. Often they are products that are exchanged for money, but they can also be something less tangible, such as services, an idea, labor, or even status. For instance, in exchange of their tuition fee, and perseverance, students get a meaningful education. In exchange for voting of a political party, voters are given certain promises by the party leader regarding the policy or to be pursued. So the process of exchange is also a process that creates, communicates, delivers value. Both parties involved in transaction gain something of value in exchange for something they are prepared to part with, and because the needs are satisfied and the result of the transactions they are better off. Now there are different levels of marketing. Origin of marketing date back to the era of bartering. Basically, bartering when goods were exchanged for other goods. The practice was widespread in the primitive societies. Bartering was an exchange in kind, that is, so say no money changes hands, and those involved in the exchange were only interested in products they want. Bartering remained popular even when the currency traveling salesman and the shop simplifies the process of exchange. In the 21st century, bartering is still an important form of trade, basically international trade in many countries, and one that calls a market oriented approach. Market can be conducted and studied on different levels. If we are considering those who make the marketing decision in a company, we are referring to the micro marketing. However, because marketing at the social level and at the sector of the branch of industry level offer important leads for marketers in an organization, we will first consider macro marketing and meso marketing. Macro marketing, if rather than looking at the marketing from the point of view of individual company, we see it at the broader level as a process that must function effectively for a society as a whole to realize its economic objectives. We are talking about macro marketing. At this level, the role of marketing is described only in general terms. After all, when it comes to the macro marketing, we are primarily interested in the system that a society has developed to arrange the exchange of goods and services to ensure that its scarce resources will meet the need as effectively as possible. Today, because of the new media, satellite connections and means of transport, marketing functions are implemented more efficiently than ever. Improved communication system, transaction possibilities and the methods of distribution simplify the marketing process at macro level. Yet these tools and the techniques are also important for the marketers, for the less they cost. The most efficient and organized marketing strategy, which is considered in macro marketing. Now let's think about the meso marketing. So far we have distinguished two different approaches to the study of marketing, macro marketing and the commonly referred to as micro marketing. Meso marketing occurs at the level that lies between two. This form of marketing is best analyzed when the framework of the supply chain. The supply chain is historically people produced things largely to meet their own needs. This system of the direct production was later replaced by a macro efficient approach in the line with the economic principles. Division of labor, specialization and the principle of exchange gave rise to the system of a production and the trade in which different parties within society were dependent on one another. We can depict this system by referring to the supply chain. The series of persons and organizations from the original manufacturer to the customer involved in the production, distribution and consumption of products and services. If these individuals are organizations, in the supply chain organize marketing activities, they do so at the level of meso marketing. The marketing system consists of a various horizontal selection or links. One such link, which is made up of the companies that perform the same function in the production or the trade of a certain product, is known as a sector. Within such sector, a group of formations that is similar in the life of in its production techniques and end product is known as the branch of industry. The money flows in another direction together with the information flow that moves from the buyer to the manufacturer, because retailers and wholesalers are proximately to do the consumer. They are able to give the producer an accurate insight into the need and want of the market and relationship of the customer. In practice, each link adds value to the product or services. If the added value that a certain link contributes is too small, it is eventually lose its function in the chain. Wholesalers, for instance, are constantly threatened with the prospects of losing their place in the chain. The party that adds the least value is also the weakest link in the chain. If you want to define meso marketing, we can say marketing activities designed to meet a certain need that parties in the supply chain carry out jointly fall within the domain of meso marketing. One example is the collective advertising campaign for the milk, which is financed by the organizations operating at different level in the supply chain, united within the branch organization. In other words, meso marketing is generally confined to a certain sector or society. We can now define meso marketing as all activities developing by several collaborating organizations within a supply chain or a sector to match the supply and demand and meet the certain need in order to release their shared marketing objective. The term meso marketing can be used for a collective activities of organization in a specified sector or of a companies with a common interest. It is also used to refer the collective marketing of certain type of products. Micro marketing. While macro marketing referred to society as a whole and meso marketing referred to collaborating organization in a supply chain, the focus of micro marketing is the individual form. What we are concerned here, that in the sense we will be analyzing problem from the point of view of managers who make the decisions. Marketing management is always planning, implementing a constant evaluation of all activities designed to ensure that the products and the services produced and provided by the organization are tailored to meet the need and want of potential customer as effective as possible. In practice, this means formulation and implementation of a product promotion, price and distribution policy that enables company to approach the market successfully and accomplish its marketing objective. A marketing manager always tries to see his company from the viewpoint of his customers. He begins by conducting marketing research to identify the needs, want and ideas of potential buyers, which in turn help him develop products and services to meet the desires of the target group. Then ensuring that the target audience is well informed by promotion, he can offer these products and services to a target market for a right price and though best sales channels. Finally, he stays in touch with his customer to make sure that they are indeed satisfied. The process of strategy development and the business decision making, which does not always occur in their order, should be based on the marketing concept. Development of the marketing mindset. Focusing on the consumer when developing a strategy seems to be logical, that we might wonder why companies ever did anything else. Until shortly after the Second World War, however, most products were so scarce that there was no major competition. So there was no real incentive to adopt product to the want of customer. Most consumers sold everything they were able to make and put forth no effort to offer products and the consumers might prefer. The shift to marketing orientation in the business sector in India was stimulated by several multinationals such as Unilever that were exposed in marketing. If we go to European and American markets, the American invasion of European market in the 60s simply accelerated its development because American organizations bought their own market research bureaus and advertising agencies with them. This led many European companies to become increasingly interested in marketing. In fact, since the Industrial Revolution, most sectors have gone through a series of phases. Over time, emphasis has shifted from production to product to selling to market. Still, many companies have not yet reached the last phase of marketing-oriented management with its manufacturers of customers' product were pioneers in this process. Producers of industrial goods, services, providers, retailers, and not-for-profit organizers roughly in that order follow them. Unfortunately, many organizations are still product-oriented or selling-oriented. However, an increasing number of managers are clearly aware of this importance of market-oriented approach. They now think in terms of market and the people rather than seeing the product as a point of departure. Before exploring this mindset, let's examine the management philosophies that originally dominate the business sector, the product or the product-oriented and the selling orientation. Thank you.
Thank you very much for the class and watching. I have learned a lot. Did you? Have a good day from the learner.